Most of us have seen Finding Nemo, but did you know that when Nemo's mum was eaten, his dad should really have turned into a female? The majority of fish found on the reef undergo sex change at some stage during their lives. This process, peculiar though it may seem, allows fish to have as many offspring as possible. The most common form of change is from female to male, known as protogeny. It only takes a few males to fertilise a large number of eggs, so it makes sense for the majority of fish in a school to be female. As females, each individual can have offspring as soon as they mature. If they started life as males, only a few would have the chance to pass on their genes due to the strong competition amongst male rivals. Protogeny is common amongst parrotfish, wrasse, anthias, and damselfish. Sex change from male to female is called protandry. It is less common and occurs in fish that live in pairs and those with solitary lifestyles. In these cases, it is most productive for the largest fish to be female, since the larger they are, the more eggs they can carry. Sex change can be triggered by size or stress levels. In anemone fish, the large female dominates the male, continually nipping at his fins to maintain high levels of stress. However, if the female dies, the nipping stops. Stress levels drop, and the male will soon change sex to replace the female. That's why Marlin should have become Marlena.